I'm Brook Lee, and this is Modern Wahine Hawaii. Welcome to Modern Wahine Hawaii. We're here at busy Kalaeloa Airport, and I am here at Paradise Helicopters with Lia Young Hunt. Hi, Lia. She's with Goldwings Supply, and we are going to be talking about everything Goldwings Supply. Let's take our masks off. We're socially distanced. How are you?
I'm fine. Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming on the show. I'm so excited to be talking about women in aviation because it's so important, especially for a lot of the young women out there who are watching or thinking about getting into this field. So let's start at the beginning because you've been in the aviation world for a while.
It's been my entire life, actually. So my father actually started a business, but he was also an aircraft mechanic at first. And I grew up surrounded by parts and aviation equipment. Grew up on the south ramp of Honolulu International.
Wow.
So I, throughout the last 30 years, have gained tremendous industry experience. After college, I came back home and I got my aircraft mechanics degree over at Honolulu Community College, and then went on to become a private pilot.
Nice. Yeah. So explain to everybody what exactly it is that your business does.
So Goldwings Supply Service started off as an aircraft parts store. So we're like a NAPA store of sorts. And over the years, we've morphed into a technology systems integrator. And what was always interesting to me was that aviation is such a rigorous industry. And so it allowed us to spread our wings, so to speak, and venture into different transportation sectors. So we provide resilient and innovative solutions to government and military organizations, including private sector and commercial, within not just aviation, but also in roadways, waterways, outdoor spaces.
Wow.
We also work throughout the Hawaii communities and throughout the US and actually worldwide with our military
installations. And so what does that look like to the average person? You're talking like infrastructure, lighting on the runways, like all of those things that help make everyone else's life easier when they're trying to commute and do the daily things of getting places, right?
Yeah, we specialize in critical infrastructure and defense. So real quickly, that just means like our highways, like you said, our waterways, our harbors, airports, you know, that's all like the fun stuff to me. That's where I thrive.
That's your lane.
Yeah. I love it. Yeah.
That's so fun because when you start just a little you, right, on the runway with your dad, to, you know, let's go to the next level, Dad. Let's take it to the next level. I mean, that's amazing. And here in Hawaii, especially, because a lot of need, it's an island. That's an important thing. Things need to get here. Things need to leave here. How's it going to happen? Then they have to come look you up, see? Now, when you're growing up in the business in aviation, what did it look like as you were coming up? Were there a lot of women around that you could like look to and sort of pattern yourself after, or did you have to sort of forge your own way? Like, what was that like?
Yeah, I think, you know, I mean, this is it's such an important topic for women, especially because of where we started and where we are now. And also the important roles that women have played throughout aviation history, from Rosie the Riveter until like what we see right now globally. So, you know, for me, when I started off, it was in aviation mechanic school, and there were only two other.
Yeah, let's be honest. Was there a lot of girls?
A lot of women. There were two other women with me. We started off with a class with about 35, and then we ended up graduating just 12. So it's a very rigorous program to begin with. So starting off with three women, we all three of us graduated. So it was, we retained, you know, our in fact, grew that static quota. But it's so exciting because there is such a big space for women in aviation, and it's a need. There's a huge shortage with not just aviation maintenance technicians, but also pilots globally.
And so if, you know, there are young women out there that are coming up, especially here in Hawaii, because I know they have a lot of aviation programs for young women that they do, like at the Aviation Museum and all of these ROTC programs, where do they start? Like, where do you kind of find your place? Is it like, oh, if I'm good at math, or if I, you know, do I have, my dad has to be in the business? this? How does it work?
Yeah, well, one thing, I'm actually on the advisory board of Honolulu Community College's aeronautical school. So we actually have something in our backyard that is one of the top schools in the nation. So if you are interested in aviation maintenance, you know, it is a two-year program. I'm big on trades. And, you know, you take a Aviation 100 and then you go through the program at HCC.
When people hear aeronautics, they get a little intimidated, don't you think? Like, you think, I gotta know calculus, I'm gonna be like, I'm gonna go to the moon.
Yeah,
right? They think astrophysics, but it's really, it's a trade. You can learn the trade. You don't necessarily need to be Harvard graduate, calculus from Moanalua
High
School.
Yes.
You know, it's a trade that you can learn. It's doable. Mm-hmm.
It's very attainable right home here. It's very affordable. And one of our biggest employers, Hawaiian Airlines, takes the majority of the graduates. And
really?
So it really is a fantastic program that actually connects with community and directly, you know, elevates the aviation community overall.
Mm-hmm. And I mean, I know it's a biased question because, you know, it's a women's program and we're women and all, but what do you think is that one sort of thing about, you know, women in this business? Because I do feel like women in these sort of male dominated in the past, they connect, they just do things differently. They they solve problems in a different way, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I think, well, women in general are very collaborative. So we love to give and we love to see collective success. So to me, that's what I've always recognized is the teamwork aspect of it, the willingness to provide space for other people and to work together and come up with the best result. And I think that when you look at a system like an airport, you know, collectively you have all of these different sectors, it's really important to have that communication and that collaboration. So I think that's a huge advantage, you know, for us women.
Well, thank you so much for coming on the show. And so everything that you've been doing to forge the way for the next women that are coming up in aviation, I really appreciate you taking the time to come on the show. So thanks so
much.
You're
welcome. Thanks for having me. So appreciative.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back to busy Kalaeloa Airport. Here I am with Tianna Castillo, who is a pilot with Paradise Helicopters. Hi.
Hi, Brooke.
Let's go and take our masks off because we are socially distanced. How are you?
I'm great. How are you?
I'm good. I'm so excited to be in your offices today. We're focusing on women in aviation and, you know, it's a male sort of dominated, you know, sector of the world, but that's changing. So what made you decide to get involved in being a pilot?
Well, ever since I was a kid, I was always interested in flying. But I think what I remember what first sparked it is I grew up on my mom's horse farm and we were surrounded by cotton fields. And they used to use airplanes, crop dusting. But one year they used a helicopter and I was probably, I don't know, 12 years old, and I sat out there and was watching, and I thought, that looks like so much fun. I think that's what first, sparked my interest in helicopters. And then fast forward a little bit, when I was 19, my dad and I took a trip to Alaska, and we stayed in this lodge. There was a pamphlet that offered a helicopter tour landing on a glacier.
Wow.
And I was like, Dad, can we please do this? And he was like, okay. So. We took a helicopter tour, landed on the glacier, and I probably asked the pilot 20 questions about the helicopter. And then I asked him how he got there. How did you become a pilot? You know, were you in the military? And he went to a flight school on the mainland and just worked his way up to doing tours in Alaska.
Got it. And what brought you to Hawaii?
Pilot school.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So.
All the way from Alaska in your head, you were like, I'm going to Hawaii.
Well, the other thing I really loved was the beach. I think that was probably another dream of mine, was the idea of living on a beautiful island, palm trees and the beach, and it's warm. And I grew up in West Texas, which is a little bit of a desert.
Right.
So I finished college in Waco, Texas, and I graduated. I sat down with my dad and he said, what do you want to do? Where do you see yourself? And I said, Dad, do you remember that helicopter ride that we took? I said, that's what I want to do. And he said, well, good luck and I support you. So then I got a job. I worked for about 3.5 years. I saved all the money I could and I moved to Oahu and I attended Mauna Loa Helicopters, a flight school here on the island. And I just haven't left yet. I love it here.
Nice. So what do you think? Is there a lot of like women helicopter pilots when you were coming up? Like, what's it been like in the environment?
Yeah, it's been, there has been a few women and they have all stood out. I think several, you know, women that I went through school with come up. One of my flight instructors, her name was Pam. She actually flies in Alaska now. And I really admired her and looked up to her. Yeah.
So what's your favorite tour that you give when you're up there in the skies in your office?
Yeah. Well, I really love flying around Oahu. But here at Paradise, we offer several different tours at a Kapolei as well as up at the Turtle Bay Resort. So at a Kapolei, you can fly all the way around the island. At a Turtle Bay, we offer down to Diamond Head and then along the east side of the island. But I think my favorite tour would probably be the Valley Waterfall Explorer, because we just get to spend a little more time in those valleys. Mm-hmm. There's this area on the northeast side of Oahu. It's lush valleys and ridgelines. And I think for me, it's just one of the most beautiful places I've seen. And we also are able to land up on a ridgeline. So we offer a landing in the tour.
Oh, wow.
And you come in and you land up on this ridgeline and you just get this beautiful view of a pristine, almost prehistoric valley. And it's quiet up there.
So you put a helicopter down on a mountain.
Yes.
Then you wait, because I saw the safety briefing, you wait. And then they get out of the helicopter?
Yes.
And they get to like look where they're at on a mountain? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
That seems like a good day at the office.
It is. It's great.
Why do people go there? Is it like, I mean, it's part of a tour, but do they mm-hmm. do special things like get engaged or have a baby reveal? Like what
are they? They do. There are surprise engagements. So sometimes I'll know about it.
Right.
Well, you know, it's sometimes the landing is a surprise. So I'll say something like, you know, there's this hike I've been wanting to do. We're gonna go get a closer look.
Oh, so one of them doesn't even know you're putting the helicopter down.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah. So then kind of surprise, come in and land and then.
Nice.
Yeah, very exciting.
And then, so I hear you're a windward girl. You live on the other side, your country side.
Yes.
What do you like about the tour when you go to the windward side?
I love the Ko'olau mountain range. It's absolutely beautiful and it extends, you know, half of Oahu. And it's really amazing you're flying through this valley and then you come over that ridgeline and it opens up. And you'll see out in Kaneohe Bay and all along the ridgeline. I think that's also one of my favorite things about flying around this island is it's very diverse. You can go into downtown Waikiki and then within just a few minutes you're up in these.
And there's nothing around.
Yeah.
So that's awesome. Well, thank you so much for being on the show.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
I can't wait because you're gonna take us up in your cubicle to your office.
Yep.
And then we're gonna get to see everything up there. What's like one tip you could give people before they've never been on a helicopter before?
One tip. I would say that look outside and just enjoy the view. You know, have your phone and take videos and pictures, but we're up there and we're seeing places that sometimes you can't see from below. So
awesome. Yeah. Well, I can't wait to come see your office. Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.
Don't go anywhere. When we come back, we're going up.
We're up here in the Paradise Helicopter Offices! We're about to take the tour and it's gonna be amazing! We're so excited! Alright guys, we're just coming up on Pearl Harbor here. And then coming up off our right side is the USS Missouri. This was the ship taken to Tokyo Bay that the Japanese boarded beside their surrender of World War II. And just ahead of it, you'll see the USS Arizona Memorial, the bridge here built over the whole of the Arizona. 1,177 soldiers that perished on board that ship as it sunk. And you can see the ferry there taking people to visit the memorial. Now we're just passing over the H3 highway. This was built to connect the Navy base there at Pearl Harbor with the Kalaeloa Marine Corps base, which is located on the other side of the island. It's said to be one of the most expensive highways ever built in the U.S. It cuts underneath the mountain range at the head through two large tunnels. We're just climbing up here into the Kalaeloa mountain range. This was a super volcano that erupted 2.5 million years ago, and that's what formed the side of the island we're headed to next. It's so green! Yeah, it's beautiful. We're making our way out here over Kalaeloa Bay. So again, the mountain range behind us was the volcano that erupted 2.5 million years ago. But what you don't see is the other half of it out in front, because over time it eroded and then it slid out into the ocean. And that's why we have the shallow waters up here in Kalaeloa Bay, as well as the sandbar. This area is like a boater's paradise, so people will boat and kayak out here, and when they get to the shallow water, they can just walk around in the sand. It's like 3 feet deep. But up ahead here, we're going to be getting into some of the valleys up on this northeast side of Oahu. Coming up down on your left is Mokulii Island. It's just off the Kalaeloa Beach Park. But next up down on your left there is the Kalaeloa Ranch Visitor Center. So the Kalaeloa Ranch expands about 4,000 acres around the ridgeline here on your left and then into the next valley. That valley up ahead is Ka'ava Valley. It's also known as Jurassic Valley. Keep an eye out for pterodactyls. The Kalaeloa Ranch offers different tours in the valley. We have ATV rides, horseback riding, or e-bikes, but they go along the roads you see here on your left to some of the different movie sets. Make our way into this valley and get a closer look. So the road you'll see going down the middle of the valley, that was used in 51st States. That's where Adam Sandler broke down every day. You'll see some, looks like white pieces there on the left side of the valley. That's the bones they used for King Kong. You also see some cows out there, Kalaeloa's working cattle ranch. And then next up, this valley we'll fly into. It's a more narrow valley, but in the very back is Sacred Falls. It's the tallest waterfall on Oahu. There's several streams up in these mountains, and when it rains a lot, all the water comes to this one area and then down the side of the mountain. There it is, just there on your left.
So you can only see this waterfall from the air, right?
Yes, there's no hikes to this waterfall. Off your right side there is a town of Laie. There's the Polynesian Cultural Center there, as well as the Brigham Young University. We're just approaching the North Shore. Off to our right side is the Turtle Bay Resort. So it is right up on this side of the island.
We were not kidding about the surf.
Yeah, it looks like some nice sets rolling in today, so we'll make our way up here offshore. Now just off your left is Ehukai Beach and then the Bonsai Pipeline. So there's an area here from the formation of the island. As those waves come in, they accelerate up a gradual slope and then they barrel over and create a pipe the surfers ride through. And this is where most of the surf competitions take place in our winter months. Now next up here down on your left is Waimea Bay. Famous for its shore break.
also Eddie Aitau, who was a big wave surfer here back in the 1970s, and he'd surf the big waves that would come into Waimea. He was also the first lifeguard in Waimea Bay, and this time he rescued over 500 people. So next up, we're going to head down the Central Valley. It's a very large valley between the two mountain ranges that make up the island, the Ko'olau, which is off our left-hand side, and then the Waianae, which is off our right-hand side. And these are the two ancient volcanoes that erupted millions of years ago to create the island. The Central Valley here is where, if you can imagine it, over time, the lava flows from those two volcanoes met in the middle, united themselves, and now we have the whole island of Oahu. And now we're just making our way over the dill plantation. So all these fields you see underneath us are pineapples. Takes about 18 months for one pineapple to grow. And the red in the soil here is the high iron content. That's from the ancient volcanic rock. It turned to soil over time and oxidized, but rusted and turned red.
Touchdown! Don't go anywhere, we'll be right back.
Well, that's our show for today, Hawaii. I hope you learned as much about women in aviation as I did here at busy Kalaeloa Airport. Thank you so much to the women who came on my show today, and thank you to Paradise Helicopters. Thanks to Lia Young Hunt, who is the Chief Educational Officer and President over there at Goldwing Supply. We're so honored to have her on our show and listen to her wonderful story. Check out that program she was talking about at Honolulu Community College. We need more women in aviation. Thank you to Paradise Helicopters for letting us come down here. And Tianna Castillo, our wonderful pilot who took us up in her office. We had such a great time, me and the crew, checking out all the beautiful things that you could see on their tours. We got to see the Sacred Falls. We got to check out all of the different places on the windward side. Check them out if you can, because it's really a once in a lifetime experience. And she's such a smooth operator. You're going to love being up in the sky with her. We felt so safe. It was amazing. Now don't forget, we're still in the middle of things here. So we're going to, you know, wash our hands, socially distance, wear those masks where we can. We're doing really well, Hawaii, and I'll see all of you next week.